listen to that wind. He is living a nightmare. No flights out of town, his hotel flooded, and now no power. A local man is stuck in this disaster. He's trapped in New Jersey tonight.
And he's taking us through his frustrating, grueling 24 hours, sharing his videos with us step by step as his overseas trip to Slovakia is halted, leaving him stranded and now in the dark.
Transformers blew up. Now we just got to sit here and wait.
Michael Cromally talking by candlelight from Franklin Lakes, New Jersey.
Power is out. They're saying well over a million people right now are without power.
He's being pounded by Sandy's sustained winds and heavy rain.
The most frightening experience so far is happening right now. Living through a hurricane, having 60 mile per hour winds outside of you with no power. You could hear the tree banging off of the house, but you don't know what's happening outside of you. You know there's some sort of destruction happening.
The nightmare began when his flight to Europe was canceled last night.
I wanted to contact him because I don't know. It will be a few hours, few minutes. You don't know what this is.
This woman cries, prevented from seeing her ill father in Poland. Michael says the passengers had to fight to get the airline to put them up in a hotel. But this is what they faced when they were sent to a hotel in Jersey City. The Hudson River spilling over the banks, flooding out buildings.
We're telling everyone who are in low-lying areas in Jersey City that they should ASAP relocate, evacuate, and go first to family and friends in higher-lying areas, either out of the city or in Jersey City.
This is the evacuation letter he received offering help to get to New York or a shelter in New Jersey.
There was an evacuation from our hotel today that our airlines put us in. And that was sort of frightening because I had nowhere to go. They said you can go to a shelter, but there was no shelter nearby. So luckily my friends took me in up in northern New Jersey.
So Michael says he's now waiting out the storm, hoping to get to Slovakia by Wednesday, but it doesn't look good. He says he's grateful he had those friends in Franklin Lakes, where he is now hunkered down.